The best thing about Pokemon Sword and Shield is, of course, the Pokemon. Except all these fucking Pokemon, because these Pokemon are not coming to the Galar region. And some of these hurt. They really miss an opportunity, for example, for Punk Squirtle Squad here. But we all know that would demolish Sobble's inexplicable popularity. Grookey Gang, Grookey Gang, Grookey Gang.
Grookey Gang, Grookey Gang, Grookey Gang, Grookey Gang, Grookey Gang, Grookey Gang, Grookey Gang.
But seriously, these new Pokemon are some frickin' hot fire. I don't know, I haven't played a Pokemon in the main series in a long time, so I'm not what you would call a Pokemon expert. But I feel like I dig almost all of these new Pokemon. They got Metal Godzillamon. They got Spooky Cronightmon. Looks straight out of Bloodborne. They got this spiky toy Turtlemon. He's no Squirtle, but he's, you know, some style. Got some spikes. Honestly, I think this will be the most Kino lineup of Pokemon since the original 151. And you have a lot of Galarian form Pokemon, like the absolutely adorable Rainbow Ponyta. This Ponyta is the Rainbow Bright of Ponyta and Pokemon. Someone saw She-Ra at Game Freak, they saw the flying horse Pegasus guy, and they were like, yas, that's going in Pokemon now. They revealed this Pokemon during the weirdest Nintendo livestream event ever, and it was basically just footage of a trippy mushroom forest. So trippy mushroom forest confirmed. I mean, what's not to love there? My favorite new Pokemon, of course, because you know how we do at higher level gaming, has to be the new Galarian form of the OG Weezing. Now the best part about the new Weezing is you can smoke OG Kush out of him. That's old money Kush right there. You know this is a rich man's bong. Look at those fancy, illegally dumped toxic waste mustaches. And don't even trip, bro, if you get the munchies after, there's all creamy. The cream Pokemon. This Pokemon Dynamaxes into a giant cake. Need I say more? I don't know, I may be the lowest common denominator, but you show me cake creatures and I buy your game. Zigzagoon is razzle-dazzled out like a World War I British warship, and his evolution, Linoon, has a new evolution, Obstagoon, who is basically a Kiss band member snuck into a Pokemon game as an anthropomorphized skunk person. And there is rumored to be more, including, and this is spoilers, but I mean the game comes out today, Rapidash, of course, I mean, lol, that one is not a spoiler. We know if there's Rainbow Ponyta, there's gonna be Rainbow Rapidash. Corsola, Mr. Mime, who is actually just revealed, he's got some new cool tones, aesthetics, and Meowth is supposed to have a new form as well. There's more, but I don't care about them, and of course, we're probably gonna get Farfetch'd because he has a new dope evolution, but it's exclusive to Pokemon Sword though. God damn it! I need that fucking Ponyta though, and it's in Shield. See, this is how they sell you two games that are not actually two games. The Haunted Teacup is straight up some Studio Ghibli shit. And again, it really incorporates that British aesthetic and British feel. Where's the Crumpet Pokemon? Crumpets, fancy cake and tea, British Pokemon be like. Roly Coly is the only good rock Pokemon since Gen 3. Morpeko, we finally have Hamtaros in Pokemon, guys. This one is half electric mouse, too. There was a little hanky panky going on with the Pikachu at some point in his lineage. Impidimp. Why do people like Impidimp? I don't know, but that's okay. Finally, there's the Gigantamaxes for when you got a heavy flow. These, I was afraid I wouldn't be a fan of. Fighting giant Pokemon, it's just not really appealing to me. It's potentially a great fix to a plot hole from Season 1 where there's this fucking huge Dragonite that no one has an explanation to, but besides this, I don't really feel the giant Pokemon decision. Then I saw them. The Gigantamax forms of the OGs, I mean, these are just as good as the Galarian forms. Fat Pikachu. Are you serious? This is literally meme. A meme Pokemon. Whoever made this at Game Freak, they definitely know this. Do you know what else is a meme? It's an old one, kiddos, but long cats. Cats but they're long. Well, they did that meme too. Gigantamax mouth. He's like 9 stories long. And there's Gigantamax Eevee, who also's looking old money AF with his floofy fur, that old white lady from the 20s mink scarf aesthetic he's got going on. Very cute. All in all, Gigantamax will be a cool change of pace and mix up battles in a way that makes this region and this game distinct from all the others. But I can understand the contempt from series fans who wanted other newly introduced mechanics to come back this time. Those are all the official Pokemon, and I can't wait to see all the rest once I eventually finish Death Stranding and pick this game up. It will be my first unknown dive into the franchise in about a decade, and one I am anticipating with great expectations. What do you think? Who's your favorite Pokemon from the new Sword and Shield games? Are you a fan of Fat Pikachu, or maybe you're a fan of the new Pokemon? Whatever you like, let me know in the comments down below. You can also subscribe to Higher Level Gaming to always see when we post videos like this one, as well as politics in gaming, game news, Let's Plays, and more. But above all else, don't forget to go play some video games and have a nice day.